Can I have the lights off, please? Okay. So I want all of you to close your eyes. That's better. So all of you, please close your eyes. Take out your phones. Go to the message box and, keeping your eyes closed, type out TEDx Bits Goa. Try it out. It's interesting. The outcome is interesting. Okay, can you have the lights back on? Alright, I'm guessing most of you didn't even reach your message box, leave alone type out anything that made sense. And those of you who did probably had keypads on their phones. If you notice, there's a little dot on number 5 of your keypad. And that is what helps you navigate through the numbers when you can't see them. So, if one dot on a keypad can make so much difference, think of those who are deprived of this luxury of vision day in, day out. They use a system of raised dots to read and write. And Project Mudra is about teaching this system of raised dot, that's Braille. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sanskriti Davle. I'm a student of BE Computer Science at BITS Pilani, Goa. And I'm here to talk about Project Mudra. Project Mudra is a Braille dicta teacher. It basically helps you to learn the Braille alphabet using speech controls. So, it consists of three things. One is Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi is a credit card sized computer with customizable pins, so you can essentially use it for introductory electronics, robotics, hacking sort of stuff. Second component is Python, the programming language. Third one is Braille hardware, which we built from scratch. And you combine all these, you write the appropriate programs, and what you have is Project Mudra. Now, what is Mudra? It's a Braille dicta teacher, which means you give it speech input and it will give you tactile Braille output. You can essentially say something and it will give you the appropriate Braille representation. So this is how you learn the alphabet. You talk to it. It's a self-learning teaching aid device. This is the rough schematic. That's speech, that's Raspberry Pi, and that's the Braille hardware output. So essentially, Mudra is a very intuitive way of learning the Braille alphabet. It's relevant because there are very few adequately trained teachers compared to the number of visually impaired people in the world today. There are 285 million visually impaired people in the world. Every 5 seconds, somebody goes blind. And if you're blind, the only way you can read and write is through Braille. Braille is your passport to literacy. So even if you lose your sight sometime later in your life, you would be an illiterate essentially. You'd be able to talk or listen, but for reading and writing, you use Braille. So Mudra is important because it teaches you this. It's like a first step to literacy. And so there's a plethora of Braille-based devices and accessibility aids available for visually impaired people. For example, on most elevators these days, that's a good sign, you find Braille symbols on the keys or the buttons on the elevators. But all of these aids, like books and everything, they assume previous knowledge of the letters. And it's pretty tough to learn on your own. So Mudra is trying to bridge the gap between not knowing any Braille and being able to use all the accessibility aids available out there. It is this gap that we're hoping to bridge by the means of Mudra. Now I'm going to hand it over to Aman, my colleague, and he'll talk to you about the other parts.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Aman Shivastav. I'm a computer science undergrad at Bidh Philani University, Goa campus. I'm going to be talking about the different modes of operation of this device that we have made. So in browse mode, the user is basically asked for a speech input, which is subsequently transferred to the corresponding Braille character. Now, basically what browse mode does is any character, alphabet, numeral, you can just speak out and it converts that to the corresponding output in Braille. Then we have auto mode, which is essentially a predetermined sequential audio tactile output. What I mean by that is, in a loop from A to B, you could just put on your headphones, attach the device and feel the different characters under your fingers simultaneously as you hear them in your ear. So sequential audio tactile output. What we do essentially here is we basically reinforce the learning by focusing on the other two senses like touch and hear, and this makes it more intuitive to learn Braille. I'm going to talk about future plans. We plan to make a custom speech recognition system which should be offline. Currently we're using the Google speech recognition engines to convert speech input to text. This will be a really big plus to it if we are able to make a speech recognition engine which will be offline. We plan to increase the number of modes, like exam mode, which basically tests the user on his knowledge of Braille by generating a random character and asks the user to guess that particular character by speaking to the device. That's exam mode. In the future, we plan to have many more modes like this, extend the whole device to a higher resolution and better user interface. Thanks. This is our website, projectmudra.com. Do look us up. That's our Facebook page and Twitter handle. Thank you.